And for more on the issue this morning, we're bringing in Fair Oaks Assemblyman Roger Niello. He's joining us for this week's Capitol Corner segment, and thanks for coming in.
Good morning. Happy to be here on an early Sunday morning.
Glad to hear it. Not so early, though, anymore. Yeah. You are in favor of extending the April 1st deadline for gas stations to meet compliance with these new clean air standards, but isn't that unfair to all those gas stations that have already paid to put in this equipment?
Well, the problem is that there's a varying ability to provide the resources to make these retrofits, and the technology has only been available for the last couple of years. There was only one supplier in 07. Second supplier came on board the latter part of last year, and right at that time, the economy collapsed with a huge problem in the credit markets, so smaller stations, especially in rural areas, are tremendously disadvantaged.
As I understand it, air pollution control district officers are saying they won't shut down gas stations and they won't impose severe penalties unless there's just a complete ignoring of the law. So isn't that an indication this is not going to be drastic shutdowns, huge penalties right away?
If I'm a gas station and I'm not fully in compliance, even if actions are pending and there is the ability to impose fines, I'm going to be awfully nervous in continuing to operate out of compliance merely by verbal assurances.
What do you think of the ARB so far declining to extend this deadline?
Well, frankly, the ARB is showing a significant lack of sensitivity to any economic impacts, all the way from their initial implementation of the Global Warming Act implementation to this and other issues. Rarely are the economic impacts fully considered in what they do, so I'm not particularly satisfied.
As I understand, AB 96 provides $8 million in grants to help these gas stations. Wouldn't that be a significant part of the solution?
Sure, that would help quite a bit. Again, we're talking about smaller stations, especially in rural areas where the options are limited, and they just don't have the financial might to be able to do this with their own funds, and we have very difficult credit markets.
So, and the governor is on board in asking the ARB to relax this rule.
He is, and I'm very happy to see that.
All right. Let's move on to the statewide special election that's coming up on May 19th.
That's right. There's an election.
It is coming. Well, it's, you know, we wouldn't want to have a year without one, right?
Yeah.
The state Republican Party Executive Council is going to meet in Sacramento later this month to decide about taking a position on the governor's reforms.
Right.
The expectation is that they're going to take a position against the governor's reforms. What would be the implications of that?
Well, I don't know what the implications of the executive...
What's it say about the party?
About the party. I am on that executive committee, and so I will be there on the 18th, and I will argue the case in favor of those initiatives as a key part to the budget package that we put together. But most importantly, the spending cap, because this is a signature Republican issue that we're getting mostly opposition from Republicans on. It's because of the tide of the taxes. The fact of the matter is, if we didn't settle the budget and we went into the gradual illiquidity of the state, the impact of that across the state, both public and private sector, would have been absolutely devastating. And we achieved a significant number of reforms. But the spending cap is going to help us in the future, when we recover again, to keep us from spending all of that increased revenue so we run into the same kind of problem that we have now. It's a very important reform. And I just think the party needs to keep that in proportion.
What about this school of thought that the measures ought to be rejected, California experiences a virtual meltdown, and then is reborn as somehow a better and more productive state?
Not all of my conservative friends think that, but there are a few. And I have just pointed out to them, we can't deny that California is still a blue state. And to assume that the phoenix that's going to rise out of those ashes is going to be a red phoenix when we are indeed in a blue state, I think is a very, very faulty assumption.
Well, clearly this package has caused a bit of a schism in the Republican Party. And here's what one of your party's leaders had to say about that during the state convention earlier this year.
We don't want to be the circular firing squad where everybody says Republicans gather and beat themselves up.
And yet, John Fleischman is opposed to the spending cap and to these reforms. What do you make of that?
What's interesting, what he said is exactly what he espoused at the convention itself when he proposed that the six of us that voted for the budget be censored. So I'm not quite sure what he mentioned, what he means by that, but we do need to allow for serious differences in opinions as to how to solve our state's significant problems without going into a circular firing squad.
Is there a circular firing squad in effect here right now?
I don't think so. There was certainly a lot of frustration at the convention, and there were people that were upset with our vote. That needed to be aired and vented, and that was fine. But the discussions that we've had since are by and large good discussions. I've debated with John Coupel a few times. We are still good friends. I'll be at the executive committee on the 18th, and we'll have a good discussion.
And you saw the PPIC poll showing that the numbers were not strong for any of these measures and that the public's view of the legislature and the governor is still fairly low. How difficult is it going to be, especially in this short time frame, to pass these measures?
It's going to be very difficult because you're right, there's a short time frame, plus it'll be a very low turnout election, which tends to be more conservative. That's where a lot of the concern is coming from. We just have to try to make a very good case. And you're right, people are skeptical about legislators. Frankly, we kind of deserve it, and we're trying to set things back on track.
All right, the election is May 19th.
May 19th.
Roger Niello, thank you for coming in on this early Sunday morning.
Thank you, Kevin. All right.